Gregor is a linguist himself, so I suppose he has some appreciation for what we are doing here. Thank you for coming.
Just a few words of welcome. I welcome you on the behalf of the Faculty of Arts here at our faculty to this third edition, as you said, of this event of translation technologies. I think this edition is devoted to machine translations. It is a promising field. So I think it is a good thing to welcome here at the Faculty of Arts, I think, participants of different backgrounds. I think you are not all linguists, or am I mistaken? I think this is a sort of a... linguistics in general is no more so self-sufficient. So also
we are all interdisciplinary linguists.
Multidisciplinary linguists coming, I think, from different fields, subfields, and so on. So I think it's a good thing, yes, because we could benefit all from this collaboration between linguistics and other fields of research, of technology, and so on. So I really wish you a nice, pleasant stay here, a nice summer school. So I think you will still have a choice and a chance to grab some latest bits of summer. The summer is going away. This is the final. I think this is the final week of this kind of summer. But I think you will still enjoy your stay here. Stay here. So I wish you a fruitful work and so keep going on. Thank you.
Translation. The first Transtech was in 2013 in Riga. The second was 2 years ago here in Vienna. So by now we are traditional. But the first two editions had more an overview character. So we tried to introduce as many translation technologies as possible, including some localization, CAT tools, audiovisual translation, and so on. This year we decided to focus specifically on machine translation. Now, do I need to explain why? It's simply because we believe that this is an area which has already revolutionized and will continue to revolutionize the field of translation. So we believe that it deserves an entire week of lectures, workshops, exercises, and so on. What I forgot to mention, the school has also been traditionally organized in collaboration between the University of Ljubljana, the Department of Translation, and the Slovenian Language Technologies Society. Right. Now, I'd like to introduce the lecturers briefly. I'll start in order of appearance, according to the schedule. Professor Martin Volk is currently head of the Institute of Computational Linguistics at the University of Zurich. He's been working in the field of machine translation for, I guess, over a quarter of a century, so quite a long time. I mean, his other research interests include information retrieval and extraction, multilingual technologies, corpus building, processing historical texts, but a lot of work, most of his work is dedicated to machine translation, and throughout his career he has basically researched all kinds of machine translation. So he had projects involving hybrid, then SMT, then I think one of your recent projects is dedicated to NMT, so to neural machine translation. Martin has also moved around quite a bit throughout his career. He has spent some time in the States, spent a few years working in the industry at the Eurospider company. I think that our acquaintance goes back to those times. Then you spent a couple of years lecturing at the University of Stockholm in Sweden, and for the past, I don't know how many, a number of years, you've been based in Zurich. So thanks for coming, Martin. Our second lecturer is Alberto Gabriel Salao. It's difficult to say which affiliation exactly he belongs to.
I'll tell you later. Basically, you can say I come from the Copenhagen Business School, but I do many other things that I will tell you in a minute.
Okay, so Bartha is basically, he's a famous person in post-editing. Now, he was seriously one of the first researchers to start really delving into the process of post-editing in the early days, when this was still quite an unknown field, not only from the area of quality and what it means for translators, but also from the cognitive point of view. And on the other hand, so Bartó is he has published numerous research articles. A book is on the way to be published within 2 weeks. But from Bartó, you can expect to get the best of both worlds, right? Because not only is he a researcher, he is also currently based in the industry. So he is a localization manager for Under Armour. And manages 24 languages, so he is very much rooted also in the practical world, which I think is a nice combination, so that you don't get only the academic perspective, but also the practical one. Then we have Nancy Matisse, who is not here with us because she will be lecturing online via Blackboard. She is basically the guru of translation project management. She has been with us since the first Transtech. Otherwise, she runs her own company based in Brussels, where she manages localization, translation projects, and so on, and has agreed to lecture to us on translation projects involving MT. So she will have two sessions with you online, discussing aspects of project management when the projects involve MT. Then we have the so-called bonus lecturers. Oliver is already in Ljubljana, but he couldn't join us here today, but you will meet him. Oliver Chulo is now based at the University of Leipzig. He used to be based at the University of Mainz, and is a also an established researcher in the field of corpus linguistics, also post-editing, cognitive aspects of translation process, and so on. And there will be two members of the University of Ljubljana. One is Dalia Fischer, a colleague of mine, also a professor here at the Department of Translation. Dalia is a person with many functions, so she is here partly as a member of our department, but also as a representative of the CLARIN User Involvement Group. CLARIN is an organization supporting this summer school, and Dalia will tomorrow have a brief session explaining the resources, the corpora and tools that you can access via CLARIN, because perhaps not all of you are familiar with this important infrastructure. And her third function is that she is currently president of the Slovenian Language Technology Society, so she's a lady with many talents. And then there's me, and I won't be introducing myself because I suppose many of you know me. I've also worked here at the Department of Translation for quite some time, and I'm really glad that we are having this third edition of the summer school, and it's become traditional by now. Okay, we have to thank our sponsors as always, so this is not don't turn off, this is not a commercial break. We are seriously grateful to everyone who supported the school. So one is Karin, I mentioned already. The second is Altplus, a language service provider from Slovenia, who has been supporting our activities since the very beginning. So they have, I think, for the first edition already generously donated to the school. Then Text Shuttle. Is a Swiss-based company co-managed by Martin Volk. So this is our third sponsor, and the organizers I've mentioned already. Okay, now some organizational matters. I hope you have all already registered for our e-learning platform. Have you done that? Please do. So it's Moodle. Perhaps some of you are already familiar with Moodle. If you're not, I hope you can find your way around it. You can change the language somewhere from Slovenian to English. and the version just changed, so I find it slightly confusing, but I hope you can find it. We sent you this link per email, so you should find it in your emails, right? So create your username and then enroll yourselves into the Transtech 17. E-classroom. We are recording the sessions, which reminds me that perhaps I have to stand near the camera. We are recording the sessions with the intention of publishing the lectures at the e-learning platform of a project that I'm currently managing, the DigiLing. So I hope you all agree. I mean, we won't be recording you, basically. We're recording the lectures most of the time. But in a way, it's good also perhaps for your benefit if you miss something or if you want to review something that has been said, you can always refer back to